Hello everyone, you are watching Dorukhan. Now I am going to record the part 2 video with the 4 more episodes that I am planning to beat the next 4 stage, getting this Space Wolf Dreadnought, one pack, then 3 of the Skull Takers and another card pack. And for that I am planning to use this deck. I want to return to Watch Captain Artemis. In fact, I have beaten the first two with the Logan Grimnar, and I believe Logan is actually pretty strong. However, due to once again my inner sources, not this stage, however, I think at the fifth or fourth one, someone is waiting for me, which is of course the gentleman on the background image, Scarbrand. And thus, I have already prepared for him. I have brought the Watch Captain Artemis, and I believe I am going to use this first match just to simply get warmed up to this. This is really closer to my regular ranked Watch Captain Artemis build. In fact, this is the deck perhaps I could use if I had 199 points. Only guy that I have issues with is Tigerius, who has only 2 shields instead of 3, and which can be quite broken with the Death Blow and various other sources. Regardless, let's go ahead and see whether if we can win or not. For I think around 1 hour I'm going to accumulate the 8 energy, and I think the 8 stage is left. And thus, if I manage to not lose a single match, I believe I can actually finish this campaign. And we are up against another Skull Taker, okay. But yeah, the issue with the Skull Taker, I think, will be... yeah, he will fill this spot with its dudes. Alright, I believe there is another Berserker is coming. Alright, but I expected the same. So in fact I am simply going to use this. I will use melee attack as a retaliation source. Though I believe it may not be enough to take them down with my Artemis. I have some issues, concerns. My melee retaliation will be able to take down the Berserker on the center. At least they are not that high of a level. I hope their own levels are also affected by the modification or modifier that we are applied to. We have around 1/3 of melee charge, so around maybe 12-13. I think it would be good enough. However, we are up against Skull Taker, so it most likely will not be good enough. Yeah, most likely I should go with Psychic and reduce their melee attack as well. And once it's really low, I should strike for a double or triple kill. I think I can make at least a double kill. Alright, also with this strategy, as you can see, I haven't lost a single card. But of course, I believe in the next round with their strike, my center and top left unit will fall. Also, yeah, Avernus unfortunately will not be able to take them down. Oh, also, yeah. This is really not good, but unfortunately I need to take this approach. I can take the Strandlers with my Furious Charge units, but do I have any Furious Charge units? Yeah, I have one Imperial Fist unit left in here, and perhaps with... I should have put this unit on the very right. If the Artemis hits the center, okay. We are safe. We are going to take down the center unit with our Furious Charge. If they wish to go with melee, yes, they will take us down. Ah, okay, they will not. Actually, if they were to attack, it would be much more advantageous for them. With this, I believe I have deployed my fourth card, so there are four more cards in my deck and one of my warlords, so I can still retract a 100% HP out of them. Now, as you can see here, if they were to attack, they will most likely one third of, I think around 14, yeah right, 28, 42, no, much more than that. Let's say 60, around 20-ish, 90-ish, 18 let's say, they can hit us for 72, and yeah, they can give us a triple kill, so the best case scenario is for us to attack and at least force them to make a less advantageous, less efficacious attack on here. Yes, we will lose our left and right flank. However, okay, nice. Are you the one who has higher health? Okay, these are also easier targets. Most likely the next one will be Karnzar. Yeah, still 1/3, he will hit around 80, so we should be able to hit. I think just to be safe, I will put my Tigris on the very center. That's really lovely, thank you. I can also put the Nial on there. Yeah, why don't we put it like that? I am actually hoping something very specific for my Tigris to at least save up a single shield to be tanked by the opponent. Okay, now the Nial will actually take down the Berserker on the left with its Psionic Blast, which will be really cool. After that, yeah, we can go melee, but it won't really make any difference actually. Yeah, I can't really move that unit over there, even though we will have some attacks and around. Yeah, pretty bad actually. It will hit around 33. Okay, I can't really see the future right now. Artemis's special will actually change a lot. Yeah, as you can. Okay, this was actually one of the best case scenario that could have happened with a 1/3 of a chance. For why? Now the Nial will actually take Metallicus down. Now that the Tigris will take down the final Berserk unit, and the lovely thing is Skull Taker will be deployed on the center, Furious Charge will hit on the shield, melee attack will hit on the Tigris, and Tigris will actually survive, so we can hit them with 60-ish damage. Also, Nial is perfectly safe on the very left, which is another good thing. We can simply hit them a really strong psychic attack. And if I at least have a single card left, and yes, I have, as you can see from the bottom right, I generally forgot to check there. And yeah, yeah, Corsair Okan isn't really that weak, so it can actually survive against Skull Taker as well. Of course, we will not be able to take them down in a single attack. No, or do we? Yes, yeah. All right then. Much easier than I have anticipated, and all right, much easier than I have anticipated, and I think this deck will actually do wonders against our next matchup. Once again, Artemis is actually pretty strong, and with some clever plays, I believe I should succeed. So without further ado, I will simply continue three more matches. This was the first one. I am clicking to continue, taking my 5 copies of the Dreadnought. Yeah, the first reward is taken of this part 2 episode. Now the next one will be a card pack. I would love to point out another fact that as opposed to general public, I am not really comfortable with playing a deck that is specified at a really same level. It's like a challenge. I simply dedicate a lot of time and effort to you know, take advantage all the free packs, kill packs, specific things, exploitations here and there. And then the game simply tells me, yeah, this in this mode, each and every single one of you are equal. I think a little bit capitalist spirited. Okay, if I keep the Tigris on the left, even though the 20% damage reduction with 1/5 will reduce up to 51, and I will actually kill my opponent. Or I can actually do kill that one with my librarian as well, I think. Yeah, let's go ahead and see that. For if I put my librarian right from the Tiger is, then my surge will simply go empty. Alright, relatively easier. Yeah, the only bad thing is for them to make that. I don't want my Corsair account to be damaged, actually. Nor do I want to spend the Furious Charges of my cards. They simply provide too much of a functionality. Also, stupid Slanesh is too fast. Yeah, serves them right. They couldn't kill a single guy. But of course, one of our shield stacks have been removed by a pesky taunt card. And another one comes, of course. Lovely. Of course, our psychic actually bypasses their melee. However, I still am not appreciating this current turning of events. Also, I don't like Slanesh. Alright, in the Skull Taker deck, I think there was 3 Bloodletter cards. Yeah, they are targeting us, okay. Once again, I will use the melee at the very end, and I think if we can simply isolate the mask down, the game will be much simpler. Another lovely thing is happening before my eyes. The demon on the center only has 51 attack, and they do not have a single psychic attack. And once the target acquired is removed, that card will not simply be able to kill Tigris. However, Tigris will be able to kill that one. So we will score a double kill. And yeah, this Seeker will also fall, as our wolf is fallen. Actually, yeah, that Seeker went down way faster than I have anticipated. Okay. Yeah, though, that's pretty bad, and I don't have the Nial. That's pretty bad. Okay. So no matter what I do, I still love you. Okay. 20% will be removed around 8, so librarian will hit 30, which will leave 15. I don't want to make this calculation on my head. Regardless, I can't get away in the easy way with my Furious Charge units. Its attack simply will not be good enough. This third taunt unit was just a little bit too much on me. Also, yeah, I don't like this level reduction. For me, it's a level reduction. Yeah. Of course, I am happy all for the newer players, for they have an equal chance. Alright, at least this target acquired simply went for nothing. They haven't caught any of the strategically important cards of ours. Alright. I think right now I can take them down, or should I? Yeah. Should I? I can use one of my... Yeah, let's go ahead. Just to be safe, let's put the Furious Charge units on the right. Let's... yeah, of course one third of a chance we are going to hit that one. Of course we will kill that one. Why would I think the otherwise? I think I have around double charge, so... This... Yeah, I think this should be the best. I have the memory of a fish, so most of the time I remember my boosts incorrectly. Also, thank you, Lysor. Thank you. That was pretty cool. Of course, the stupid Slaanesh passive will actually function for the first time, and we will receive 51 damage. I believe the final card will be Slesk. Otherwise, it wouldn't be that challenging. And considering it will be level 3, if it will be matched against the classic, matched against the Corsair Khan most likely, I'm going to take him down. That's actually pretty cool. Okay, I can work around that one. Only funny thing is my Corsair Khan. Also, they couldn't manage to kill me, which is pretty weird. Okay, I have no option but to attack them with melee. I will lose Lysor. Rest in peace, Space Marine. However, we will draw the first blood on the mask. Only 8-4 is left. I will move the Avernus on the right, and simply Nial will get me the game. I just love this guy too much. I try to use it in every deck, even in the Logan Grimnar decks. Frost Wolves are cool, both in lore-wise and the color scheme-wise. Do tell me which one is your favorite Space Marine chapter in the comments. And yeah, we are one damage short on killing the mask. Hinge on a single. They will. Of course, they will select ranged. We don't even have a single ranged. And Avernus will die. I think if I were to select melee, I would have killed that one. But for some reason, I have subconsciously selected the safest approach. I can't directly control my strategies anymore. Subconscious takes the control. Okay, that triple demonet was actually pretty annoying. However, for our sheer luck, we actually dodged many of the target acquired cards. The luck was on our side. Perhaps with the simple dex construction. Target acquires only targeted cards that were already at the verge of death. So nothing did change. So this was the second mission. Two more to come. Regular card pack. Yeah, we have killed three demonets. The game has given us two. Yeah, this is like the smaller Lysor. Also, guys, by the way, both Swiftwind and Lysor cost 12. However, in my opinion, Lysor is much better, for he unlocks at a later account level, if I'm not mistaken. So, if you were to run a 12 cost Space Marine with a Furious Charge, do please run Imperial Fist Lysor instead of this White Scar Swiftwind. Just a friendly reminder. Also, Ishmael is here. Zekeriya is here. Yeah, Brother Adrimo is here. I am not really stoked to see him. And I think I have got yet another energy, so my episode 3 can be seen as well. So most likely this will be the main event for us. I believe I am ready. I believe I have been warm to this deck. In fact, I was playing Watch Captain Artemis for over a couple of days. For hours today, I was preparing a project report, and I have finally finished it. And I am ready to blow off some steam out of this guy. So let's go. Also, I would love to make a statement. I have speak spoken with many of my subscribers, and they have actually shared many of their decks that they have beaten the Scarbrand. I bring that, sure man. If I didn't know this guy's lore, I would be scared right now. Strength, able to deliver devastating melee attacks to multiple targets, so you are Logan Grimnar. Weaknesses, weakness unknown. Because the guy is stupid, man. As far as I know, thanks to my inner intelligence sources, yeah, that's Logan Grimnar. And Skull Taker but boosted, not 25 but 30, so curse you. I love Skull Taker and I don't like Skull Taker copycats. 22, around 60%, will hit around 15-ish, so 37 will not be good enough to take me down. The only bad thing is, oh okay, wait, I hope it won't be, yeah, if I keep my Tigris on the center, the death blow will hit, so two stacks of the shield will be taken down. However, if I keep the Tigris on the left, Furious Charge and the Cleaver's attack will actually take me down. So it's a pretty bad scenario for me. Also, currently I have no idea who will Artemis hit. Yeah, it didn't really matter. The single attack on the blood letter wasn't really beneficial in any way. Perhaps if I have had put my librarian on the right, with the attack of the Nial, we could have taken down. Let me quickly calculate. Yeah, it's already dead, but 38 times 60. 22 plus 18, I think we were to hit 33. I think, yes, we were going to kill that one. Yeah, the safest approach, unfortunately, the Cornate Berserk enemy survived. However, we will kill that one with the next round's Psionic Blast. Unfortunately, of course, the Tigris will be unnecessarily damaged. However, for now, I think we are in a safe spot. Yeah, they can't hit me for 42. If I'm not mistaken, right? Yeah, for the game itself limits their levels as well, so we are in a safe spot. Also, Tigris will be able to take the Berserker down quite easy. However, the next round we will not be able to take them down. Yeah, actually we will not be able to take any one of them down. Yeah, quite annoying. Yeah, even if we weren't outflanked, I would love to take assistance of my Furious Charge cards in the next round. Yeah, for I believe I will lose many of them. Look at that cute dual egg swift, also saved by 7. If I'm not mistaken, 2 X's of the Scarbrand is actually named. Named something specific, I cannot remember the name. Unfortunately. Let me go ahead and attack this guy. Okay, it's dead. Furious Charge will be able to take them down and I can actually go with melee. Yeah, I think from my experience from the previous game, the card that will come will be matched with the Lysor. So yeah, the Furious Charge will take them down. Oh, the Furious Charge will take them down. Yeah, I will hit with Psychic, so everything will be good. Scarbrand will come, attack with 88, so whatever I put, I think it will kill. However, if I put my Corsair Okan, it will not be able to kill, right? Yes. Yeah, let's go ahead and test this theory. For 88 plus 30, it means 118. Ah, lovely. Okay, now I can actually ready melee 2 times. Ranged won't really make any difference. Yes. That's a really weird scenario right now. Regardless, we have charged our melee actually. Now, what I'm hoping is the second card most likely the greater demon to match. Lovely. Okay, okay. Yeah, Thysaur can be killed. All right. How to say? Corsair Okan will actually do the jump. Also, I didn't realize this guy was this much health, had this much health, which is actually pretty problematic for me. Yeah, also that wasn't really nice. Okay, yeah, we will reduce their attack, but won't really make much of a difference. I think instead of adding the Tigris, I should have put Corsaro on the very left. Yeah, the most likely I should put, yeah, no matter what I put, it will not make any difference. 118, it won't matter. I don't think I can take this down. The wound point is actually absurd right now. I changed my mind. Okay, all we need to do is to hit with the... you tell me. Watch Captain Artemis stack. We... okay. With 200, I think we are in a safe spot. Yeah, they will attack with their melee. And in fact, they couldn't kill my... yeah, the Skull Taker passive. Okay, also pretty cool. I right now have a triple charge. With triple charge, I can hit them 108. With 108, it will receive as a lot. That's a lot of damage. But still not good enough, I think. Yeah, let's go ahead and hit with the... Okay, it's game over. Okay, pretty cool. Even if I haven't killed this guy, my strategy will be hit them with the psychic on the left corner and finish up with my triple with the Watch Captain Artemis. This is how I play with the Watch Captain Artemis. As cancerous as possible. More slaughter, more carnage. Bro, chill. Why I didn't take this guy seriously? I very much advise you to read his lore. Because in the lore, as many of the characters, Scarbrand starts his story very strong. He is the favorite of the Khorne. He is a bloodletter, just like the Skull Taker, older than him. Really strong, like the imagine a regular bloodletter, but full-on steroids, okay? Destroying worlds, claiming skulls, Khorne's favorite, make him proud. Anyways, days go by and simply this guy isn't the most intelligent one and he is deceived by the Tzeentch and Tzeentch tell him, yo bro, just go ahead and kill the Khorne, you know, the take your double axes, just hit him in the head and simply take the throne, you'll be the blood god. Then Scarbrand says, yeah man, that's pretty cool. Of course, up until this point, Tzeentch is continuously manipulates the guy, plays on its ego and pride. However, at the very end, Scarbrand loses its final brain cell to think that he could actually take out the blood god Khorne himself. So, in an, I think, celebration, in a moment of distraction, Khorne simply looks elsewhere and at this moment, Scarbrand strikes with his full might of his double axe and all he can hit or damage is a single little how to say chink on his armor, and Blood God simply looks at him, gets pissed, holds him at the throat, and as you can see even at this screenshot right here, you can see his skull's right place is actually rendered, the face is damaged. He Khorne chokes Scarbrand so hard and burns him, throws him to the warp and the guy actually turns into a meteor, and I don't know how long does he travel, but like a shooting star he then impacts on some planet or some place, and from there he's simply wreaks havoc as well. So this is your regular stupid brute force muscular guy. And I think currently the most favorite blood letter of the Korn is the gentleman blood skull taker currently. However Scarbrand is still in the story, and this will be the fourth match, and let's go fourth and final match. And I think he worked with Musk in a story against Robot Gilliman, but yeah, they have been kicked in the butt. So yeah, as most of the Chaos characters, they are not really characters that can be taken seriously, unfortunately, like Abaddon. Because if they even win one time, one of the good guys is to die, and we can't really have that. Just like that, I believe it will be a similar kind of guy. Alright, levels are the same. I mean, I have no option but to deploy my psychic cards in my Watch Captain Artemis deck. This is my first line of defense. Most of the most likely, yeah, they will have this kind of dude. Yeah, pretty annoying. How much do they? Yeah, on the 25, I thought it would be changed, just like the Scarbrand thing. Nothing upgraded, I believe. Perhaps the deck itself upgraded, right? It had 3 blood letters, 3. Okay, I think it has been upgraded. I think this should be the best. Yeah, okay. Alright, Niall's melee attack will be actually take down the blood letter if they go for melee, but I think they will. Our next psychic attack will not be able to take down Korbadash, which will be a shame. Not dead yet, not dead yet, not dead yet. Retaliate! Alright. That hurts my feelings. Ah, so close. Okay, yeah, unfortunately I don't have a... even with the Niall's support, I think I will be able to hit 74. So close yet so far. Not cool at all. Going melee will not make any sense. And simply my cyber wolf on the left will die, and I accept that. And I accept. Perhaps we haven't killed anyone this round. However, next round we will start with the Niall's psionic blast, and hence we will kill. Okay, the Tigris will take the kill. I always forgot this guy has 12 melee attack. For I think its melee is like it's ranged around 4 or none as well. Okay, how much do you hit with the 60% of 39? I think it should be good enough. Calculator open. 39 times 60. We hit around 24. It's more than enough. Yeah, but I think of course. I can go melee as well, just to kill that. Okay, it's still not good enough to take down the Berserk with a psychic blast. I mean, how much can a bloodletter can hit me? Even with a double attack, all they can hit me like 4, right? And yeah, rejoice mortal, for we can actually kill them all. Alright, now with this, the final 3 cards will be unlocked. The most likely the my issue will be my positioning. The Skull Taker will come, the Furious Charge will take the Niall, they will attack melee, most likely Lysor will die. All I am hoping is Tigris to survive, however I think the Greater Demon will be faced with him. Oof, yeah, that's pretty rough. I think I have my Librarian left. okay, as expected. Yeah, their melee attack will be more than good enough. Yeah, that's pretty rough. I can also, excuse me, do it like this. Four. Wait, why is your wound is too? Of course, for the levels of this card has been reduced. All right. Anyway, we still have 30 attacks left. Will be left. Okay. So I can attack Skulltaker two times with my psychic, meaning a 76 will be achieved. I will hit the Furious Charge on the left, perhaps with my regular attack, Ishmael's regular attack, they will be able to take them down. Lovely special rule positioning over there. Yes, I think this game is already over. I am simply selecting Psychic, yes they have outflanked us, reduced our melee. However, our retaliation damage will still not be changed. Yeah, also our librarian has a melee attack as well. In my opinion, this Blood Angel Assault Terminator is the one that is carrying us. For most of the Chaos cards have actually melee. The Glagotrops have melee, the... you tell me. I think I can, but why should I, right? Yeah, there is no need to rush. The game's ours, so why not have fun? I think this was the fourth episode, right? Yeah, the Scarbrand was the third. Yeah, Walk in the Park. Hearing from your stories, I actually expected much harder. I am not shaming you or anything. However, yeah, just be safe. Always be safe. You can never know. Just kidding. But of course, after playing really excessively in the ranked, my subconscious still doesn't let me. And this will be the fourth win and sixth consecutive win. And I think this should be the end of the second episode. Four, let me quickly check. Yeah, we have already passed the 38 minute mark. And let me not make this longer than it should be. Let me go ahead and take my final, not final, but the next reward. And after that, I am going to try to take the reward of Belial. Yeah, much better rewards. I love this Brother Garrus. I have also given this guy a chance, Koprax the Wolver Breaker, in my Abaddon deck. So in case if any one of you is interested, I can make one episode with him. Brother Mortar is appearing a lot, in fact. I think today only I have received three of his copies. I hate this card. Yes. So also I realized I am one energy short and maybe after 1 hour I can play. However, by that time most likely I will be really sleepy and I don't want to play this event while I am really sleepy, for I think I will make mistakes and I really don't want to mess up this undefeated run for you. If you don't believe me, you can check the energies. I was actually pretty sure that I was to lose at one point. However, once again, this Artemis deck is simply too much to handle for any of the Chaos cards, in my opinion. And I don't think I will change this deck, guys. I can tap on both Psychic and Melee, and I can even select ranged on Artemis as well. Too versatile to sacrifice, just so you know. I hope you have been entertained. I am also pretty happy with this campaign, even though it is modifiers. I actually do wonder if the same modifiers will apply the tomorrow's part 2. However, we can we can't know without seeing it ourselves. I hope all of you will achieve all these rewards. Mostly, it will be first time Belial for me. Also, getting 3 copies of the Skulltaker is pretty cool. If you want to know how Skulltaker functions and you have no prior experience, I have a Skulltaker video that have actually achieved 2700 in the ranked. And I also have Abaddon video. And in that Skulltaker video, you also have Korbadash, the first reward, the Berserker reward also in there. Yeah, just so you know. And until the Episode 3, the final episode. I would love you to take good care of yourselves, guys.